Hi viewers, this is NEPTV. For the first time in the history of Indian TV channels, NEP,
that is Natural Environmental Protection TV, proudly presents you
a live telecast, an interesting, thought-provoking interview with great personalities of nature.
A live show on Save Me. Rain, river and forest play an important role in sustaining life on Earth. Rain is the source of river and forest provides and protects the rainwater. They are correlated.
But nowadays, they are critically endangered. Hope this show will reveal the truth and enlighten you. Here comes the farmer's family from the village. Let us ask them something about water and agriculture.
Hi sir, how are you? Is everything fine?
Huh, nothing is fine. Why are you troubling us?
What do you want from us?
You seem to be going somewhere. Where?
Yes, we are leaving our Kallupatti, our favorite village, our native place.
Why? Why do you do so?
It's all of fate. What to say?
We want food.
We have no means to live.
There is no rain, no water, no cultivation.
What shall we do? Our fertile land turns to be arid lands. So we have to leave.
Leaving your own village? Where are you going?
Where to go? To the nearby town only.
What will you do there?
What to do? By all means, we have to work.
I have to find some work. Maybe a coolie to feed my family.
Hi ladies, where are you going with empty cans?
Oh my, there's no drinking water. Everything is empty.
Water comes in the tap once in a week. Today's our turn to come. We don't know when it would come. I got up at 3 o'clock in the morning to fetch water, but still.
Oh, really?
The day is going to be over, waiting still for water. My children didn't even have their breakfast.
Waiting, waiting. Half of our life is spent only on waiting for water.
What a life, chasing after water.
I didn't have even a cup of tea from the morning.
Oh, what a pity.
Here come the geologist and ecologist. Let us listen to them.
Hi viewers, I am a geologist. This is just an sample. The same and the even worse situations occur in most parts of our India today.
Even Sirabunji, the highest rainfall region, is short of drinking water today simply because it does not capture the rainfalls over it.
Do you know one thing? Water is the driver of nature.
Nearly 1,884,000,000 people do not have access to clean and safe water.
Okay, viewers.
Let us now move on to a fabulous picnic spot, the waterfalls and the river.
And slowly then to the nearby forest.
For that, you have to walk 5 miles. Come on, walk with us.
We can take some beautiful snaps of rivers and trees. Come on, let us go. Oh, I'm so tired of walking.
Don't worry, we can enjoy and rest there in the forest.
Oh my goodness, we are far, far away from the city. Still, we don't find the river.
We have found the river.
Found the river? Where? Where is it?
Here it is. Here is the river. We are on the river only.
Are you joking?
Not at all. It's the fact. We are standing on the river.
Then, where is the water?
There is no water. It's dry.
My goodness, what a pity.
How does it happen?
Most of our rivers are not perennial. They depend on monsoon rains. Failure of rain results in the failure of water in the river. Proper rainwater harvesting is not followed.
So even if it rains, the excess rainwater is drained in the ocean. Very soon, we are going to see the rising tension over shared water resources.
It is ridiculous indeed.
I remember my childhood days. We used to play in the nearby forest.
Come on, let us go and show some interesting facts.
That's good. We will have plenty of fun there.
What are you looking for?
I am looking for a shady place to rest.
Listen, I hear a crying voice. Keep silence. Let us listen to the voice.
Oh, Mom, please don't cut me. Please, it's paining.
I am dying. Oh, my God, I am dying.
Don't be afraid, my child. Be firm. Stand erect. Let us face the problem boldly.
Mom, we are doing good. Only good to men. We give oxygen for them to live. Then, why are they destroying us?
It's all because of their selfish motive, my child.
Mom, here comes he. Ah. He is putting eggs on me.
Terrible indeed.
Hey, you are interviewing many persons throughout the day. Why don't you interview me?
You? Who are you? Where are you?
I am here only. Very closer to you.
Very closer? We can't see you. If you have a courage, come in front of us.
I can't come, but you are near me. You are under my shade.
We are near a tree.
Is that you? The tree speaking?
Yes, I am.
What do you want to tell us, you pleasing one?
I am a pleasing one for you because you are under me. But my life is not a pleasing one. It is going to end.
Going to end?
Yes, it is a sad story.
Story? What are you saying, my lovable one?
People like you, a group of men, came here and enjoyed my shelter.
That's good.
Wait. One day, a man came and asked me to give a branch to make the handle of an axe. I gave my branch happily. He made an axe with it and killed all my brethren one by one. Now, it's my turn. Alas, I am going to die tomorrow.
Oh, what a pity. I feel sorry for you, dear.
We won't allow you to be cut, dear.
You know, we only protect the air, produce shower, and save soil and rainwater. Then, why lakhs and lakhs of trees are put to death by the greedy and thoughtless people? It's really a pity that the people don't understand what they do. They are not destroying us. They are destroying their own life. We are slowly dying.
What a sad news.
Dear audience, you heard the cry of the trees.
You know, trees are very important for our existence in this world. They attract rain during clouds and cause rain. They protect underground springs and prevent soil erosion.
Really? It's marvelous.
There is only 30% of forest on this earth out of 400 crore hectares of forest area.
Oh my God.
Remember, trees can live without human beings, but humans cannot live without trees.
An average man approximately needs the oxygen of 16 big trees per day. But today,
36% reach the oxygen of one tree. If it continues, our life will be a question mark. Think it over.
Animals. See the deer, the rabbit. The fox, the tiger, the lion. How happy they are.
Wait. Wait a minute. They seem to be lying quietly. They are not happy.
Yeah, it's true. Hey, rabbit. Why are you so calm and quiet?
We have no grass to graze.
No green leaves to eat.
There is scarcity of water.
No food, no water.
Our kings and friends are dying of thirst and hunger.
I don't want to harm these dying companions.
What is the root cause for this disaster?
Who is the culprit?
You. It's all you.
You people kill us for skin and hair.
You give us slow poison by destroying trees
and misusing water, the nature.
That's true. We accept our fault.
Go! Go away from us!
Leave us alive!
Hello, we are from NEP TV.
TV? What? What TV?
Please, don't run. We won't harm you.
We are your friends.
Friends? What do you want to say?
We just want you to interview.
Interview? On what?
People like you come here as friends. They hunt the animals and cut the trees.
As a result, soil erosion, our soil. Soil loses fertility.
You destroy our lifestyle.
Our culture.
Our traditions.
We don't want you.
Yes,
we don't want you to be here. Move away from us.
Dear audience, on this special occasion, here we have the learned faculties, the experts, to share with you their thoughts.
Let us welcome the ecologist, Ms. Vivega. The geologist, Mr. Raj. The researcher, Professor Dr. Swaminathan. The environmentalist, Mr. Vaidyanathan.
Welcome, sir. What would you like to say to the people, sir?
Dear viewers, when a forest is destroyed by selfish people, they harm several generations of the people of its surrounding. The ecological balance on this earth has been affected.
Here is our geologist. Let us listen to his point of view.
Are using 54% of all accessible fresh water contained in rivers, lakes and underground aquifers. Irrigated agriculture currently contributes up to 40% of the world's food production, and the remaining 60% comes from the rainfed systems.
Over to our famous researcher, Professor Dr. Swaminathan.
Water is essential for agriculture and food security. It takes 1,000 to 3,000 liters of water to produce 1 kilo of rice. Since 1900, we have lost half of the world's wetlands.
Really?
Yes. Globally, we use 70% of our water sources for agriculture and irrigation and only 10% on domestic uses.
According to the World Health Organization, for every $1 invested in water and sanitation, there is an economic return of between $3 and $34. All of physical, economical and spiritual needs depend on the water and its community of life.
When we save a river, we save a major part of an ecosystem and we save ourselves as well.
Do you know the decisive factors? By 2025, 1,800 million people will be living in countries with absolute water scarcity, and 2/3 of the world populations could be under stress conditions caused by water scarcity.
There is no end to the environmental talk. On one side, glaciers are melting, and on the other side, many species of flora and fauna are fast vanishing.
This forecasts that we humans are racing to vanish from the planet if a perfect eco-balance is not maintained.
So, common strict restriction should be followed throughout the world to save the natural environment.
A few audience are coming up on the stage. Let us welcome them.
Hello.
native views.
Welcome, sir.
We were blind to the nature. You have opened our eyes and inspired us. We have to take steps immediately.
Now I have become aware of the coming forth disasters. If we don't save the nature, oh my God, I can't imagine.
The show was marvelous. I have decided to put all my efforts in whatever possible way to save the nature. I would inspire my college mates and companions also to do so.
There are only 7,000 days at our hand to save the earth, says Norman the scientist. So it is high time for us to take effective steps to save our life. That is our nature.
So friends, God forgives us always. Man forgives others at times.
But nature never forgives. It often teaches lessons by its disasters if we misuse them.
Nature is the heart of God. Nature is the gift of God. Using it is our right. But saving it is our greatest duty. We have decided to do our duty. Hope you too.
I understood when I was just a child that without water everything dies. I didn't understand until much later that no one owns water. It might rise on your property, but it just passes through. You can use it and abuse it, but it is not yours to own. It is the part of the global commons, not property, but part of our life support system.